Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Lords of the Shattered Kingdom Developer Gameplay Series. Today I will have to grind some resources and rebuild my army. Because of this, I will speed up parts of this video where I will be attacking lowly monsters or just traveling to pick up resources. By the end of the video, I will amass quite a nice amount of resources and we'll have a full complement of tier 4 melee soldiers. Enjoy! Here you see me planning on what to do because I don't have such a strong army right now and I'll probably have issues even with the most basic of enemies. So I'm checking what I can do to improve this. I'm checking what weapons I can build and realized that the blacksmith was empty. That's why I didn't have any weapons. I couldn't buy any weapons. I'm thinking to upgrade these guys to use the leather equipment, but since I don't have enough weapons, I just give up and go farm. I have too many templates saved and need to clean some of them up. Here I'm trying to find the difference between various templates. Since the last quest that I ran on the previous episode was the find the chest quest, I'm thinking that I'll be able to do that quest again and I take another quest. Now I'm just traveling to get resources and killing the Mine Guardians, so this is 4 times speed now. Okay, let's see what the new quest is all about. And I hit this map and I'm telling you, I love this map. I can be really picky with the enemies that I attack. And I'm also lucky because I see the quest item right there, so it's gonna be an easy completion. I'm lucky with a very nice battlefield, but unfortunately my archers are not all that good, so it's not that advantageous. I lose a full group of the old soldiers, but it's okay. I also get a new Lord weapon. Unfortunately, the weapon sucks. Really bad rolls, so it's useless. But I can pick up these resources and then complete the quest. As you can see, there are a lot of resources over there in the middle, but I don't have the troops to fight these enemies that are blocking my way. Lots of resources. I'm thinking about it, maybe go for it, but I simply don't have the troops for it. I decide to return, and here I'm still looking back at what I'm missing. Such a nice pile of gold. The situation is so bad that I'm actually thinking about killing the enemies on the barbarian island and collect the resources here. However, I change my mind and decide to try another quest from Michi. As you can see, I'm going for the lowest difficulty setting, because I can barely complete it like this, even on the PvP map. Now, on this map, the best idea would be for me to attack the hobgoblins. Those are guarding the biggest area, so that's the usual thing that you should do, but I go for the archers because I know I can defeat the archers with minimal losses, whereas those hobgoblins will be a real pain to fight. I want to slow those archers so that when my lord moves next to them, they will not be able to kite me. So that's why I slow them down. With these guys, I'm also going to move in such a way that the archers will not be able to shoot. Unfortunately, I'm not too careful about the hexes that the archers have open, so they end up shooting. Still, the low numbers coupled with a few flanking moves and I managed to kill them all without losing anything. So I pick up the resources and already see the mission objective there. Now I have to fight these monsters. It's a very large group, but I don't have any choice. So I attack them. And this is a great battlefield for me. There is one hobgoblin in my part of the map, but I can kill that with all of my melee soldiers jumping on him, and then I can block the entry with the Lord, which is extremely tanky, and shoot with the archer and smites and other spells to really grind the rest of the monsters. Archer is not that great, but every little bit helps. Now, instead of just blocking with the Lord, I decide to shield one of my melee troops and also involve it in the fight, because I could go 2 against 1 of that hobgoblin, and that means I will get lots of damage in and don't have to rely on the archer only. Again, the archer shooting, and this one is completely useless, it's too slow. Might. Okay, and now time to kill that hobgoblin in my part of the map, and it's time to slowly grind through those hobgoblins. And with that hobgoblin dead, I can get a flanking move on the next one. I'm thinking about it because if I do this, the goblin is going to attack me and I'm going to go 1 versus 2. But I have some plans. You will see on the next round, I'm going to pull back that soldier and pluck the hole with another one. So it's time to do my move. Haste this one so it moves next. Now I move it out and skip the cloth and move the leather back into the hole. Now the hole is blocked again. The goblin moves in, unfortunately. The goblin is quite tanky, but even so, it's again 2 of my troops against a single goblin. So it's very doable. And at this point, I already have superiority in terms of power, so it's okay. Time to do some moves and get flanking on that guy. That should take care of him. Already I have a lot of soldiers, so and he's with my back, with his back to me, and I'm gonna hit him with the soldier that I have back here, this one, and that's it. Overall, good fight, good experience, good plunder, and I managed to finish the quest. These quests can have one of those modified items. So over here I'm thinking about attacking those hobgoblins in order to check if the modified weapon is there. But since I don't want to lose more troops, I just decide to go home and call it a day. I notice here that the sword and shield soldiers are actually almost as good as the spearmen in terms of damage. So I decide, but there are more. So I decide to just take the sword and shield soldiers. And since I was lucky so far, again I take another quest from Michi, one of the challenge quests. I go to the mine, pick up the gems. It's a very good idea to pick up these gems, lots of gems, the mine refills fast, and it's a great source of gems. And I'm very happy to see that I get this map again. This time, however, I'm not as lucky. There's no quest item in sight. These are very bad. And those orcs look really bad also. Yeah, completely not fightable. So if I want to move forward, my only chance is to attack these guys, knowing that I will have losses, and I attack them. I am barely in this guy's range, so he goes for the shield soldiers, which is a good thing. I can tank with them quite well. I don't want to waste my flanking move on that guy, so I just attack from the front. Okay, now with smite on this guy, and now with the Lord I want to block any flanking moves from that guy, so I'll be able to focus on the one below, but then the one below goes sideways, so I go for flanking attacks on the one up front. And this is the sword and shield soldier, which is extremely resilient apparently, and also does nice amount of damage. And now it's an easy fight. I decide to sacrifice this guy so I don't lose the others. And that's it. And there's a modified weapon. It's a shield and also the quest item. When I take a look at these guys, however, two of them are very fast, one of them is using spears. Very, 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 very bad for me. I'm thinking to go kill those orcs on the left side, but the orcs are quite bad also. And I don't know what's on the upper part of the map. I'll have to kill two more enemies to get inside. So, with that thing in mind, I decide to just stop the progress on this quest and hopefully come back later today to finish it. I leave the map, pick up some resources and head for Michi to get another quest, and this time I'm not going to take one of the challenge quests. I'm going to get the one that gives resources and has very weak enemies on it. Of course, the least that I can do is to take it on the highest difficulty setting. You will see that the monsters in the map are really, really weak. No challenge for me. But the resources on that map are nearly the same quantity as those on the challenge maps. So it's a very good resource farming. I'll show you the quantity of the monsters in this first group. Yeah, like I said, very weak. And then I'm going to speed up the video for the remaining of the quest, because it's just grinding. Okay, now that the killing part is done, I also have collected lots of resources. It's time to build the armor that is required. Unfortunately, because of my gold issues, I cannot build them right now. As you can see, just a few armor pieces, but no worries, I have plenty of gold in the Lord, so time to return home, deposit the gold, and build the armor. Okay, some nice command experience and a bunch of upgraded cloth armor. Let's spend the command experience points. I'm going to take some damage upgrades for my soldiers. Since I'm using Maceman, I should upgrade the Blunt Weapon Mastery, or, well, yes, okay, and maybe a bit of Cloth Mastery also. I decide to start building a marketplace in order to sell the things that I don't need from the quest, like modified weapons and other stuff that drops. Also sell some of the resources that I have lots of. In this case is wood. I have lots of wood that I'm not actually needing. I could convert it to gold. So time to build a marketplace. I now get a third troop of those tier 4 soldiers, so things are looking better and better. Unfortunately, when you farm low level enemies, you will not get too much time bonus because you do not get experience, and that's closely related to the time bonus after a fight. So the weapon production is also a little bit slowed. This is offset, however, by the fact that you don't lose so many soldiers, or don't lose anything at all. You've seen me take another challenge quest. That's because I'm getting more and more confident on my troops. And the quest that I've taken here is actually one of the most difficult ones. I have to kill some enemies. That means I can be picky about it and have to kill 3, 4, 5, depending on the map, of the enemies present on the map. But the groups are the toughest ones out of all of the challenge quests. So a lot of focused power on the map. And here I'm collecting the resources at the edge of the map, and at the same time I'm checking what's on the map. I'm very happy to see that there are monsters guarding the middle area. Because that's where I want to go, that's the place richest in resources. And now that I have a clear view on the entire map, I can decide which enemies I want to attack. Obviously, I want to collect all the resources in the middle there. So, first I go for these archers. I'm checking to see how many monsters I have to kill. Those archers are target 1, this is 2, 3, and I have to think of a fourth one to attack. And this is a pretty straightforward battle. Let's see. A bit of losses, but nothing I can't handle. Still, the resources here are huge. Then, let's see these guys. Oh, they are very, very slow. So definitely I want to kill these guys, and this is probably going to be my fourth enemy that I kill. So these, then the goblins and the archer on the top right side. Nice map also. I only eyeball the range of the enemies and make a mistake, and they get the first hit on me, and that causes quite a bit of damage. Luckily, it's nothing I can't handle, and they are not tanky, so they are easily killed. I attack with the Lord to consume the retaliation, and now it's easy, I just have to dispatch them. Overall, good fight. Now, these archers are fast, that means they also have a very good range. I know that they will hit, so I have to get close to them as fast as I can, or I need to use the tanky lord and this guy which specializes in fighting against archers. And because the lord is the weakest here, I can just play around with the shield and sword guy and kill everything. So, free win here. Now time to fight the monsters. Monsters are slow, but they are tanky. Okay. And I decide to gank up on that orc over there. Checking to see how the hobgoblin is. Now, I don't want to give him a flanking move, so I just slow the hobgoblin, then his speed is gonna be 1, barely moving, and I can just move this guy over there to completely surround the orc. Move this guy forward to make room for the archer. Then the archer moves also forward. He's safe. Shoot the orc. Now it's easy to go against the orc. Kill it. And I do not attack the hobgoblin because I don't have all of my troops there. I shoot him one with the archer, and then I can attack the hobgoblin with all my forces. Surround him and get a lot of overwhelming attacks as well as a flanking attack. Here it is. And the guy is still standing. Tough monsters. Okay, now try to go for the goblin. I have no choice but to go for the goblin because he's already in range and he has speed 2. Get a flanking move on it. And now there's just very few of them left, so no problem for me. And good fight, good experience, good plunder, and huge amount of resources over here in the middle. The market is built, time to go for an upgrade. it like that, okay, upgrade, yes. Allocate more people. And let's see. Now another farming moment. So I'll speed the video up a little bit. Just taking stuff from the mines and collecting some resources from the map. Like I said, this is important because I'm lacking resources and also the gems are very good. After I collect, it's time to return to the castle and get more troops. Lovely, I now have 4 groups of tier 4 melee soldiers, which is great. I can now attack with much higher confidence. Besides that difficulty setting, there's a random element to the quest's difficulty, and you can figure out what that random element is by the amount of favor that you get from the quest. I've noticed that the next quest was giving kind of a high amount of favor. So instead of taking the first one that I wanted, I just went for the Eliminate Enemies quest, which also contains fewer enemies, and it was easier. Here you see me realize that maybe I should upgrade my archers, since I'm using only a tier 3 bow and a tier 3 equipment, and I don't lose archers, so, but I use them, so it would have been a good idea to first upgrade the archers. I don't have enough goods, so that's it. Now this map again, for a moment here I forget that I'm on the eliminate enemies, so I have to kill everyone. I can't be picky about it, and you see me check what enemies to attack, and I attack these guys, which you'll see are easily defeated. But again, you have to be careful about it. Just going face on would mean lots of losses. Okay, easy free win, mostly because the Lord is extremely tanky. Now let's see these guys. Oh, so many good resources there. Yeah, again, I'm checking, but I shouldn't have because I have to attack everything. These guys are slower than me, so it should be a very easy fight. I can get flanking, it's only one group of enemies, so no problem. Very easy fight, time to move on. Yes, I still haven't figured out that I'm on an eliminate all enemies map, so I'm being picky. But now I remember and just attack them. This is a horrible map for me. I deployed the Lord to get the bonuses from it, but I know that I'm gonna end up being bottlenecked over there, so I haste one of my damage dealers and go forward next to the archer. Unfortunately, it's not enough for me to kill him. And he's going to get one shot. I go with the archer forward, which is completely futile, but now, because the guy turned around, I get a flanking move on him and kill him in one shot. But first, I waste a shield scroll, which I'm going to regret later on, because I'm having some issues with producing spell scrolls. Over here, I remember that I saw some modified weapon on this map, and I'm thinking, where is it? Because it's actually on a similar map from another quest, so that's why the confusion. And now, this enemy can't be picky about it. They are dressed in cloth. They are very fast. Fortunately enough, they only managed to get to me but not hit me. So I can decide what to do with this. I cannot get a flanking move on the good ones with the Lord. So I have to settle for just consuming the retaliation on these guys. And then I get flanking moves with almost all of the other soldiers, which is great. And only one guy left standing, that's gonna do some damage. Still no problem. There it is. Good fight overall. Now for the final monster, archers. Not even fast ones, so should be easy. Okay, easy fight now. Time to return home. Complete the quest. I have to get 50 night marks to take that difficult quest to be able to conquer the Knight Castle. So, long way to go. Let's take another quest now. Time to upgrade the archers, and here you see me thinking about what to upgrade. Just definitely the main cloth would be good because I have plenty of them and I have them already, so definitely use that. Then I'm thinking what else to use, and I have to give him gloves. He doesn't have gloves. Definitely a new bow, maybe some boots. But in the end, I settle with just bow, robe, and gloves because I don't have enough goods in the blacksmith to also get the boots. So eventually I go for this design without the boots, and because I don't have more of the other boots, I have to settle for 25 archers only. At this point I realize that my scroll production is inadequate, so I take some of the workers from the blacksmith and assign it to the mage tower, and now as you can see I produce a lot more, and the chances to get a free scroll for the level 2 mage tower is almost 100%, plus I produce a lot of mana over here. And that means I can buy a lot of scrolls each turn. Thank you. Another eliminate enemies map, so can't be picky. I just have to kill everything, and yeah, I have to deal with all the enemies the best I can. This one is a free win, so we're off to a good start. I go with the Lord on the leftmost one because I won't be able to reach it with the others. I haste this guy so I can reach those archers. Then these archers, then these archers, and now only one left which I cannot reach, but it's okay. It's just one small group, so should be very easy to flank. I deploy my troops, he cannot reach me. I consume the retaliation with the Lord, and then flank with the next troop and overwhelm with the others. And free win. Very nasty positioning over here. Again, they blocked the way. I moved the Lord to protect from flanking, and then I plan to overwhelm the orc, take him out as fast as possible. It goes down a lot faster than I anticipated, so I can move to the hobgoblin, shoot also the hobgoblin, dies, then it's an easy fight taking care of the goblin. Another single group, I have to slow them down in order to be able to get flanking on them easy. That's what I do. Now skip all my troops, maybe shoot with the archers, not very good. Now they move over there and that pretty much blocks all my avenues of flanking, so I have to rely on the overwhelming attacks, and I hit them with all my soldiers, and it's still not enough, but their number is seriously reduced, and I suffer very little losses. Another easy fight here, flanking with the Lord, flanking with the others, then overwhelm and easy fight. Now on this quest map I was looking for that modified weapon, but it's the second map of this type which does not spawn, so it's just me being unlucky. There's a chance for a modified weapon to spawn on any of these maps. So it's just me that's not lucky. Here I miscalculate the speed of the enemy and he manages to get one hit and do a lot of damage. Most of the damage from the fight comes from that single first hit. But regardless, the quest is now complete. Lots of resources, lots of bonus time, and all of the fights gave nice amount of experience also. Over here I am thinking to upgrade the market a third time, well actually a second time upgrade, but then I change my mind and just upgrade the house, make it a level 4. Or was it the 5? Anyway, upgrade the house, that's going to increase my gold income even further. Check the gold mine, but it's almost empty because I took the gold from it on my way to the quest. Okay, time to recruit more archers to make for a full group of 31. This is what I'm doing here. So, 31 archers. And now, get reserves for the melee troops. Because I'm lacking gold, I'm going to take a quest here that gives lots of gold as a reward. This one. Just checking to make sure that I have the required quest item, and I do. So I take this quest. Oh my god, I took it on the low difficulty setting. What a big mistake I did. Okay, anyway. Good reward even on the low difficulty setting. You will see that I lose some soldiers while running the quest, but the reward is totally worth it. Those ballistas will haunt me for the entirety of the quest. The ballista is not a great weapon, but it has the advantage of having infinite range. So wherever you are on the battlefield, a ballista is going to do its damage on you, no matter what. So yeah, I'm gonna take a bit of damage from the ballistas. Time to complete the quest and lots of gold as reward, as expected. And now, finally, I'm stopped from producing more weapons by the amount of goods in the blacksmith, not by the amount of gold that I have. So that takes care of my gold problems. Again, get the gems, good gems, get some of these other resources, and with a full complement of troops, it's time for me to return to that quest where I left over and complete it. Here I eyeball the range of the soldiers, and when I see that the guy moves first and heads for the archer, I'm like, oh no, and I end up losing lots of archers here out of sheer stupidity. After that, the fight is pretty straightforward. Tank with the Lord, overwhelm with the others, and then flank the iron armor. And that's it. So I only lose the archers here because I was stupid. I did not have to attack these guys, but they are archers only, they are very slow, so I'm confident that I can kill them pretty fast and get nice experience and nice plunder out of them. As you can see, lots of rewards for a relatively easy and cheap fight. This is not a great battlefield for me, but I plan to use slow, so I'm counting hexes to see where to deploy, and this should be good. Okay, slowed on that guy, and I should be fine now. Yep, none of them are hitting me. Again, the same move, tank with the Lord. The first retaliation, then I plan to flank the others. I was hoping here that I will kill them in one hit because they are spearmen and they will go through my evasion. Then I flank these guys, lots of damage there. Then these guys, and at this point I was hoping that I'll be able to kill those spearmen. Still I can't, but their damage is severely reduced. Kill that guy. Now I get flanking on this guy. Flanking on this guy. Well, not flanking overwhelming, but anyway. Pretty decent fight. Lots of rewards. There's the quest item. There's the modified shield, which is complete garbage. Complete garbage. Positive roll on hit points, but awful roll on the evasion. So almost garbage. I'm thinking to even sell it. That's how bad it is. Resources are good, however. I'm happy with it. Complete the quest, get the time bonus. Collect the other resources and then head home. And with this, I'm planning to end the video. So what I'm doing here is just a bit of maintenance to the castles. I'm depositing the goods here, cleaning up my inventory by selling things in the marketplace. But first I'm taking a trip to the main castle because it's running out of plunder. As you can see the icon on the top of the screen, I put the plunder there, problem solved, take lots of the gold from here, 600,000, that should be enough, And then I decide to also take the other things that I want to sell in the marketplace that I now have on the Barbarian Castle. So, taking lots of stuff to sell it. I also realize that I have lots of boots here and those cloth hoodies which are still in use, so I take those to use. This quest item is old, I just drop it there, throw it away. More weapons now. Let's see. Lots of soldiers now. Plenty of reserves. Here I realized that I forgot to refill my archers. But the archers are not the main element of my army anyway, so it's okay like this. Plenty of spell scrolls now. Plenty of mana. I can get all the spells that I need. Over here, as you can see, full complement. Time to send plunder here. Now look at the gold and the changes. Lots of extra gold because of that plunder. Now the gold is positive. I'm producing gold each season. And time to sell the garbage. The clubs are so bad that the marketplace won't even give me one gold for each. Well, anyway, the resource problem is solved, and on the next video, I'll be able to take more difficult quests. We'll still be going on the challenge quest and see how far we progress. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.